very shallow. Extreme. We go to the extent only as much as we can accept. As long as he is not touching our ego, whatever he says is truth for us. We accept. We shake our head. Oh, it is great. He's a great person. He's a great Swami. He's a great Mahatma. He's a great saint. And what not? We have all the great words. The moment the person touches our ego, the moment you are not given the front row, the front row is the big idea, the front row as the VIP seat, immediately we say, oh, I think his teachings are not for me. That's the first word. The next, I think what he is saying is not going to work for others also. Then we have our own words. As long as our ego is satisfied, things go well. That's what I tell many times. Don't think I am a master, you are a follower. Many times you only behave as a master and I have to follow. I am a follower. That is what actually happens. Ramana Maharshi says beautifully. And people come, they are disciples. After some time they become masters. That's what actually happens. After some time. And one more thing, the important thing, the masters are such innocent beings. They just bend as you want. They don't usually stand. And they don't usually the masters, they are very, what to say, they are more like a breeze. They are not like a tornado. They are just like a breeze. They say, all right, if that is the case, do it as you want. Somebody goes to Ramana Maharshi and asks him, Master, what should I do for enlightenment? Bhagavan says, do self-enquiry. Enquire, who are you? After a month, he comes back. It's too difficult, Master. Can I do something else? Can I do meditation? Bhagavan says, all right, do. What can be done? After a month, again, this guy comes back and says, can I do repetition of mantra or japa? Meditation is too difficult. Bhagavan says, all right. After a month, again, this guy comes back. Can I do just bhajan instead of japa? Japa is too difficult. Again, Bhagavan says, all right. What can be done? Again, after a month, this guy comes back and says, can I do puja? I think that is the best thing for me. Again, Master says, all right. The Masters allow you, give you so much of freedom because they trust you. Masters trust the disciple. That's the reason they give so much of freedom. But the big difficulty is we can never believe that we are trustworthy. That is where the problem starts. We can never believe we are trustworthy because nobody has trusted us in our life. Either nobody trusted or we never trusted that somebody trusts us. Anybody, if they show some sign that they are trusting us, we immediately calculate. I think this guy must be having some other calculation. Must be having some reason. Otherwise, why should he trust me? Because I don't trust him. And naturally, he will also be doing the same thing. When I smile, I have my own calculation. For this benefit, I can open this much mouth. For this benefit, this is the area. This is the width. I know the calculation. When I do the calculation, naturally, he will also be doing the same thing. When somebody smiles at you, you can't trust. He's expressing his love. It's very difficult. It's very difficult. And it's very difficult to trust that others can trust you. Even in ordinary relationship, we don't trust others can trust us. If at all somebody expresses their love, really, you try to find some reason. Maybe that guy is feeling lonely, that he wants to talk to me. That's why he rang up. When they don't ring up, you say, Oh, he's not taking care. He never gives time. He never gives attention. If at all he rings up, you say, maybe he must be feeling lonely. He wants to talk to me. He wants to spend some time with me. He wants some company. And if you are not able to find any reason, you just neglect. Oh, maybe by mistake something is happening. We never trust that we are trustworthy, even in ordinary relationships. And you play a very safe game. You stretch your hands only that much. That safe distance, at any moment you must be able to take it. You will be able to take away. You play a very safe game.